Today's Big Garden Birdwatch. It's an event the RSPB have been doing for some 20 years now. It started in 1979 as a children-only event. It's only been for adults as well since 2001. And it's where we ask members of the public to sit for an hour and look at the birds in their garden or in their local park if they haven't got a garden and count them. All we need to know is the highest number of each species you see at any one time.
I can see we've got a little two blackbirds.
We have. We've got a male and a female blackbird hopping around here. But one of the reasons the Pavilion Gardens are so good is the gardener here, the head gardener here, manages the garden very much using native plants and traditional planting. So there's lots of places for birds to hide. There's evergreen plants here. There's lots of plants with berries and seeds and things that actually grow on the plant. I mean, we've put the feeders. You can see the feeders here. The RSPB have put those there to encourage more birds to the park. But if you rely entirely on your feeders, then if the feeders were empty, the birds would be in trouble if there wasn't a natural food supply nearby. But as you can see, the gardens here are very rich in native planting, which is what you need to do to encourage and look after the wildlife in your garden.
We sometimes get these, don't we? What are these?
Grapes.
They're a bit bigger, aren't they? They've got the blackbird down the front.
Thousands of people took part in the Big Garden Birdwatch at the weekend, including the Crovino family from Hanover. They've used fat balls, bird feeders and crab apples to attract more birds into their garden. Results from last year's survey showed a renaissance for birds such as the collared doves, while others, such as this song thrush, are becoming increasingly rare. Sparrows, although popular, are also on the decline.
If you do feed the birds and you start to feed them, continue to do so, because they may nest near a regular food supply and then they'll lose their food supply if you take it away, and then they've nested there and they can't feed their young. It's very important to feed them in the spring. And I mean, this is the biggest bird watch, this is the biggest bird survey in the world. It's really good fun to do, but what's key and importantly is it produces a serious piece of research that lets us know exactly how the birds in our gardens and countryside are faring. So it's very important.
At the Pavilion Gardens in Brighton, this is Andy Dickinson for the Argus.